In this example, we're going to look at adiabatic compression of a non-ideal gas. It's carbon dioxide. We're given feed conditions. We're given the outlet pressure. So we're compressing from 1 bar to 10 bar. And the question is, what is the outlet temperature and how much work do we have to put in per time if we're compressing 2.5 moles per second of carbon dioxide? And we're going to use the Peng-Robertson equation of state to model this non-ideal gas. We're also going to use the heat capacity as a function of temperature. And so we're going to use a spreadsheet that has this programmed into it. First thing we want to do is set up a diagram that represents the process. So we've put the inlet conditions to our compressor, 290 K, 1 bar, H1 and S1 are the enthalpy per mole coming in and the entropy per mole coming in. We want to determine the enthalpy leaving per mole, the entropy, so we can determine the temperature. Now we're going to assume it's reversible, otherwise we need more information about the compressor. We know it's adiabatic, so if we write down the first law for this system, and we're running this at steady state as we like to run a compressor, general first law says the change in internal energy respect to time is equal to n dot would be a molar flow rate in times enthalpy per mole minus molar flow rate out, which in this case is the same because we're at steady state, times the enthalpy per mole out plus Q dot plus W dot is the general energy balance that we will use. And then, of course, this is zero because it's steady state. This is zero because it's adiabatic. And so we have an equation for the rate that we're adding work to the system. This is going to be the total work added per time. Then is the molar flow rate, enthalpy out minus enthalpy in. So we're going to use the equation of state spreadsheet for the Peng-Robertson equation. What we're going to do for these initial conditions of 290 K and 1 bar is read off the values for H1 and S1. And I'll show you a little later in this screencast the output from this spreadsheet. So these are the input values. You have to keep in mind that these are for a specific reference condition. Spreadsheet allows us to change that reference condition, but we have to use the same reference condition for the inlet and the outlet streams. So we want to know H2. We know S2 is 90.99. We do not know T2. We know P2 is 10 bar. So in the spreadsheet, we can put in 10 bar, and then we're going to adjust T2, get the correct value for the entropy. Once we do that, we can then determine the enthalpy. It turns out 469.5 Kelvin is the temperature that gives us this entropy at this pressure. So the temperature increases significantly due to compression. We're putting energy into the gas that raises the temperature of the gas. And then we can read off the spreadsheet the value for H2. So we can now calculate the work, n dot h out minus h in, which is h2 minus h1. So 2.5 moles per second is the feed rate. 24,342 joules per mole is the outlet value for the enthalpy, and the inlet value is 70,224. So we do the calculation, convert it to kilojoules, and then correct number of significant figures that's justified at most is 2 in this problem. So we've calculated the work input per time, and we've calculated the outlet temperature. Now let's look at the spreadsheet to see what this looks like. So the inlet conditions in the spreadsheet, we have to input the critical temperature, critical pressure, and the eccentric factor. And then the heat capacity terms as a function of temperature, A plus B times T, etc., that is described in detail in this spreadsheet. And we show another screencast how to use the spreadsheet. We also input the inlet temperature and the inlet pressure. The enthalpy is here and the entropy. And then what we're going to do is for the outlet conditions, what we've changed is the pressure. And then we adjusted this. We could certainly use Excel Solver to do this, but we adjusted this temperature to make this essentially the same value, generally within significant figures. And then we can read off this exit enthalpy and calculate then the work. So for this particular example, it may not differ dramatically from an ideal gas as long as we use heat capacity as a function of temperature, but this is a more general approach as we went to higher pressures, gases that are going to be less ideal.